Good evening. Welcome to SouthLake Christian Academy's Fine Arts presentation of POIEMA, a celebration of the arts. My name is Jose Baez, and I am the Fine Arts Director. We hope the next hour and a half be an inspiring experience that will make you reflect on the greatness of our glorious God through your children's creative expression of music and visual arts. With that in mind, we ask you to applaud with enthusiasm after each musical selection. Your children have worked very hard for this concert and they deserve your encouragement. So why don't we practice right now? Everybody, give them a round of applause. I would like to give a couple of housekeeping matters before we start our concert. Restrooms are located at the lobby. We ask you to please refrain from exiting during the piece, during any musical selection being performed. Please wait for the selection to end for you to walk through the lobby. Thank you very much. Also, flash photography. Let's refrain from using flash photography and video live streaming. This concert is being filmed professionally. We have a whole team of professional videographers and multimedia experts, and they're offering this concert. We're going to upload it in our YouTube channel, so you will have access to all the captures, every single angle for this concert. Tonight's presentation has been possible thanks to the collaboration of our fabulous fine arts team, Michelle Lakey, Christy Parson, Marcus Mims, Charity Simpson, and Logan Gilmore. To all of them, thank you very much. We also wanted to thank the following people: our wonderful administration, Dr. Curlin, Mrs. Leonard, Mr. Apgart, Mrs. Makla, for the support and inspiration throughout this year. Life Fellowship Church for allowing us to use their facilities. Thank you for your hospitality. Please give it to them too. Lastly, to all of you for coming tonight and supporting your children. And now, before we start celebrating the arts, I'm going to ask our headmaster, Dr. Matt Curlin, to please come and lead us in prayer.
Let's pray. Heavenly Father, we are grateful for the students we will see on stage tonight, for the gifts and talents you have given them, and for the opportunity that you have given them to express those in front of an audience and before you. Thank you for the parents who have helped support these students with their time and their money and their efforts to help them learn and grow as artists and musicians. Thank you for our teachers and for the dedication they have to seeing these students become masters of their craft and specialists on their instruments and with their voices. Thank you that you have created us to be creators, created in your image as your workmanship, as your masterpiece. Help us to also create with the same passion and enthusiasm and love that you have displayed toward us. In Christ's name we pray. Amen. Thank you.
Thank you. the sad eyes. Don't be discouraged, though I realize it's hard to take courage in a world full of people. You can lose sight of it all. The darkness inside you makes you feel so small.
You can be amazing, you can turn a phrase into a weapon or a drug. You can be the outcast, be the backlash of somebody's lack of love. But I wonder what could happen.
See the true colors shining through. I see your true colors, and that's why I love you. So don't be afraid. I wanna see you, just wanna see you. I wanna see you, I wanna see you be brave.
Show me your smile.
Everybody's been there, everybody's
been
there.
Thank you. Good evening, SouthLake families. My name is Stuart Hodgman. I am honored to have the title of president of the Fine Arts Booster Club. We're going to address that in a minute and how that came to be. But tonight I want to share a few thoughts with you as both parent and president. First, as a parent, a little background. My wife Laurie and I have two daughters, Avery, who's in the ninth grade, and Emmy, who will be attending SouthLake next year, entering the sixth grade. Avery's been a part of the choir now for those 3 years, and we as parents have thoroughly enjoyed watching the performances and see all that goes into creating them. Last year, Avery casually mentioned there was going to be a meeting regarding the choir or arts department. My wife, Laurie, who has been volunteering and had gone on some of the competition trips, was naturally selected by child number one to attend, and in turn, Laurie asked if I wouldn't mind going as well. I think when I think back at it, this was Laurie's first strategic move. I agreed to go that evening and completely broke educational meeting protocol. I made direct eye contact with Mr. Bass. I asked questions. I was engaged. Well, what this led to was me being voted president. Again, I think my wife, being an educator, could see this coming a mile away, as I caught a wry smile through the whole process. But what was really happening was the Lord was saying, I'm going to provide to you an opportunity. In life, we are presented all the time with choices and opportunities. As parents, we are given the responsibility to make a lot of choices for our children. Rest assured, I think we have all made a great choice by selecting SouthLake Christian as a parent, a grandparent, or a guardian. A Christian education and supportive faculty, we are blessed with great people shepherding our children. Listen, every family has to make the choice that best suits them. We are blessed to have such a caring and loving environment where we can send our kids. We have such a supportive administration that listens and works with us as parents to foster and develop the best out of our kids. Now, with respect to the fine arts, we have a headmaster, you just saw him perform, that has a degree in music. It's in his educational DNA. We have such talented people here, Mr. Bass, Mrs. Lakey, Ms. Parson, Ms. Statsney. What is sad is that many schools are eliminating the arts from the curriculum, which I just find tragic. Visual arts, performing arts, musical arts, all are important. It has been proven if you look at how the brain responds in those that have versus those that do not have some aspect of arts in their education. To exercise the mind, reasoning is developed, synapses are firing. It's an easy decision to keep arts in the school system. The skill set of working as a team toward a coordinated end goal, a production, an art exhibit, a choir performance, hard work, teamwork, these are life lessons. Look at the productions these kids at SouthLake have done and been a part of. Blumenthal recognition. I know even before Avery started attending SouthLake, we were attending the performing arts. Choir competitions, just a few examples, and they excel at these and oftentimes win. Look to the scriptures, and it is clearly evident that the arts and music is encouraged. Psalm 150 states, praise the Lord, praise God in his sanctuary, praise him in his mighty heavens, praise him for his mighty deeds, praise him according to his excellent greatness, praise him with trumpet sound, praise him with lute and lyre, praise him with tambourine and dance, praise him with strings and pipe, praise him sounding cymbals. A little side note, Mr. Bass, lute and lyre. Increase the section lute and lyre. You know, at work I often relay to folks, if I'm asking you to do something and you don't understand it, or if I'm not giving you the tools to do what's being asked of you, that falls back on me as the administrator. We are asking these educators to help our kids be the best they can and to excel. We know that these educators are giving it their all, their passion. Don't you think we should do our part to make sure they have the right tools, the right instruments? So, both as parent and president, I would ask you to discuss, as a family, what can you do as a family? Is it time? Is it energy? Is it money? Consider it a part of a music tithe. These are things only you can decide, and I'm only planting the seed. As I mentioned earlier, we are presented choices and opportunities in life. What we do with these opportunities is up to us, and what a great opportunity here to make a difference in our own children's lives. I want to thank you for the opportunity to say a few words to advocate for something that is so important. Now, let's continue to make a joyful noise to the Lord.
Thank you. Cantate Domino omnis terra. Cantate Domino canticum novum. Cantate Domino omnis terra. Cantate Domino canticum novum. Cantate Domino omnis terra. Cantate Domino canticum novum. Cantate Domino omnis terra.
ladies and gents, this is the moment you've waited for.
Whoa.
Been searching in the dark, your sweat soaking through the floor.
Whoa. Buried in your bones, there's an ache that you can't ignore.
Taking a breath, stealing your mind, and all that was real is left behind. I close my eyes and I can see a world that's waiting up for me, that I call my own. Through the dark, through the door, through where no one's been before, but it feels like home.
Take my hand, will you share this with me? 'Cause darling, without you,
can keep us apart, 'cause you were the one I was meant to find.
It's up to you, and it's up to me. No one can say what we get to be.
So why don't we rewrite the stars? Maybe the world could be ours tonight.
They can say it all sounds crazy.
They can say I've lost my mind.
All the shine of a thousand spotlights, all the stars we steal from the night sky will never be enough. Never be enough. Towers of gold are still too little. These hands could hold the world, but it'll
Good evening. Thank you so much for coming tonight, and I hope you're enjoying the program so far, and it's almost over, so I'm proud of all these students, and we're especially proud of our seniors. We're losing quite a few seniors this year, and I've only been here for about a year and a half, and some of these seniors I've only worked with for a year, but it's been a special year, and they have definitely left a mark on my heart, and you'll always be my children. So I just want to recognize real quick Hannah Dillard. Macy Garrison. Belle Hester. Tanner Hurd, and Eli Poitras, and Mr. Vass will recognize his orchestra children in a little bit, but I just want to say a couple things to you. I'm sorry I'm looking behind, but you're so special to me. It's been a special year. I am very blessed to have been able to work with all of you. And I just want to encourage you as you start your new chapter in life, you're ready. You're ready to fly and soar. And I just want you to remember the gifts that God has gifted you with and continue using those for Him wherever you go. And come back and see me. I love you.
When I think about the seniors, this group of seniors in orchestra this particular year is a very special significance in my life, because when these three orchestra students came to the orchestra for the first time, they were in second grade. So this year is a decade since they joined orchestra without ceasing. So give them a round of applause. So now, you, in 10 years, a lot of things happened. We got to know each other. Probably, I have the privilege to know this students more than anyone else in the campus because of the longevity. We have developed relationships, deep conversations about the Lord, about family, about school, about education, about career, about music. The first day I met them in the classroom, I told them a guarantee, or your money back guarantee, that will make you cry of laughter. And I hope I did not. Okay. So it is a great honor, and it's very emotional, but I don't want to get into that part. But all I have to say to Jacob, to Hannah and Maddie, to stay in the Word, to stay in the Lord, no matter where you go. Jacob is going to Liberty University to study something regarding security and anti-terrorism. So our country is going to be safer because of people like Jacob. I just pray that you will be on time to deliver the country of Venezuela at this moment that they're going through a rough time. Maddie Alexanian, she's going to liberal arts in Wake Forest University and pursuing the career of her dream as she goes on. And Hannah Dillard, please, yes. Did I say it correctly? Yes. And Hannah Dillard is a recipient of the full scholarship, music scholarship from Anderson University. So she's going to pursue a career in music. So I just wanted to leave them this special token of my love, my appreciation, my very special to Maddie. To Jacob. Thank God they already played everything that they had to play now. No, they still have to sing. Hannah. Okay. And Hannah. So thank you very much. Give them another one. Thank you. Congratulations. And as we end this, as we get to the end of our concert, let me get next to the blue tape. When we think about the word poema, poema is a Greek word that means the works of the Creator. In the New Testament, we find in the New Testament that word mentioned twice, in Romans chapter 1, verse 20, and Ephesians chapter 2, verse 10. In the first passage in Romans, it talks about the creation, how the creation reveals and points to God's eternal power. It points to an existent God. The second passage says that we have been created in Christ Jesus so that we may walk in those good works that he prepared beforehand. So the first passage talks about the creation speaking and pointing towards God. And the second passage talks about we are his creation, his workmanship. Poema. Poema is an expression of God's glory. The word poema is also the root for the word poem, which is a beautiful expression combining rhythm and rhyme and using descriptive language in an artistic utterance, which is used to declare the glory of God. So tonight's celebration of the arts has been an expression of God's glory. Do you know the glory of God? Have you seen the glory of God? You see, 2 Corinthians chapter 4, 6, which is a passage very close to my heart. It says that the knowledge of the glory of God is only possible through the face of Jesus Christ. There is a way to know God in his most glorious form, and it's through the person of Christ Jesus. Do you know Christ Jesus? Do you have a relationship with God? Because poema points to God, the creation points to an existent God. We are the workmanship of God to declare his glory. But when you have a relationship with a living God, you see, you can partake of your sin have been forgiven. You have a personal, you can enter into a relationship with God because sin separates us from God. And I don't know if anyone here, any of your any family, relatives, friends, guests, have never heard, probably you have never heard these words before. But that's the mission of SouthLake Christian Academy. That's the mission of the Fine Arts Department, to declare the glory of God through the expressive arts so that we may make much of Jesus and worship him. If you have a personal relationship with God, now you can be, like Paul says in 2 Corinthians chapter 3, verse 2, we are living letters, living epistles that declares, that shines in the world of darkness. That is only possible through the person of Christ Jesus. Let's bow our heads and pray. Father, as we conclude this concert, we want to declare you as our Lord, as our Savior. And if anyone here has not trusted their life to your saving knowledge, Father, we just pray that by the power of your Holy Spirit, you declare to them, you speak to their hearts, you quicken their hearts so that they may respond to the message of the glorious gospel, that you send your only begotten Son to die on the cross in our place for our sins. But not only he died on the cross, he resurrected on the third day, which means that in the person of Christ Jesus, sin was conquered and overcame. Father, we just pray that you make that effective in each one of our lives. We just pray that you continue to quicken that word of the gospel in our lives, even for those who are veterans, for those who already know you from before. Let your name be glorified. And as the choir comes to the stage and performs the last piece of the concert, we just pray that you be glorified and exalted. In Jesus' name, amen.
Come down, shout hallelujah, praise his holy name. Sing. Lord, calm down. Shout hallelujah, praise his holy name.
Thank you so very much for being such a great audience. Thank you once again to our brethren from Life Fellowship for hosting. Give them a round of applause. What an amazing testimony of using God's resources for the kingdom and for partnering with other ministries. So we are very grateful. Thank you so much for being here tonight, and have a wonderful evening. You're dismissed.